हाय, मैं हूँ श्रुति एंड वेलकम टू माय सेकंड नेचर। मैं अक्सर सुनती हूँ कि लाइफ के स्ट्रेस की वजह से एंग्जाइटी हो रही है। यू नो, हमारे लाइफस्टाइल, कांस्टेंट रश, वैसे तो अनगिनत रीजंस हैं, लेकिन एक सेकंड रोक के अगर सोचें व्हाट इज एंग्जाइटी, अगर डिस्क्राइब करना हो तो क्या होता है कि जब एक पैनिक अटैक हो, इवन अ माइल्ड वन। चलो अभी ही डिस्क्राइब करने की कोशिश करते हैं। क्या कहेंगे कि जब दिमाग का शोर आसपास की दुनिया से ज़्यादा हो जाता है, या मे बी सांस लेना मुश्किल हो जाता है, या मे बी, वेल एक्चुअली आई कैन गो ऑन गेसिंग, लेकिन ये सब सिर्फ गेसवर्क ही होगा ना। बट वॉट इज़ द रियलिटी, किसको पता। इसीलिए खुद को थोड़ा सा आज सेल्फ अवेयर बनाते हैं, क्योंकि अगर कोई सफ़र कर रहा है एंग्जाइटी से तो उनसे तो पूछ नहीं सकते, पूछेंगे भी तो जवाब यही मिलेगा कि इट कांट बी डिस्क्राइब्ड। तो वेल, फिर पता कैसे लगे। एंड दैट्स वाई आज माइंड इट पे हम बात करेंगे विद डॉक्टर श्वेतांबरा सबरवाल, जो कि हैं एक साइकोलॉजिस्ट एंड अ साइकोथेरेपिस्ट। तो उनसे बात करते हैं अबाउट एंग्जाइटी। हेलो डॉक्टर, हाउ आर यू टुडे?
हाय श्रुति, आई एम वेरी वेल, हाउ आर यू?
वेरी गुड, डूइंग वेल। तो आज मैं एक ऐसे सवाल पे आके अटक गई हूँ, वेर आई एम सडनली फीलिंग लॉस्ट, एंड देन ऑफ कोर्स आई हैव थॉट ऑफ यू एंड थॉट के व्हाट बेटर क्वेश्चन टू आस्क यू, एंड यू आर द बेस्ट पर्सन जो एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हैं कि होता क्या है व्हेन वी गो थ्रू एंग्जाइटी। सो यू नो, फॉर समवन हु इज नेवर बीन थ्रू एंग्जाइटी और हु डजंट इवन नो, नाम बहुत बार सुना है लोगों ने, लेकिन नॉट नेसेसरीली कि उनको पता हो कि क्या है एंग्जाइटी, यू नो। सो देन लेट्स बिगिन फ्रॉम बिल्कुल ही जैसे लेमैन के तरीके में, बिल्कुल जीरो से, व्हाट इज एंग्जाइटी, हाउ डू वी अंडरस्टैंड इट?
थैंक यू फॉर ब्रिंगिंग अप सच रेलेवेंट टॉपिक्स ऑल द टाइम श्रुति, आई रियली लव योर शो फॉर दैट।
थैंक यू।
एंग्जाइटी एक इतना कंफ्यूजिंग एरिया इसलिए बन जाता है क्योंकि एंग्जाइटी एक इमोशन भी है और कुछ हद के बाद वो इमोशन को एक्सपीरियंस करने से एंग्जाइटी एक डिसऑर्डर बन जाता है। शायद इसीलिए ये बहुत कॉमनली मिसअंडरस्टूड इमोशन है, मिसअंडरस्टूड डिसऑर्डर है। टू आंसर योर क्वेश्चन, एंग्जाइटी इज बेसिकली एन इमोशन। देर इज अ गुड साइड टू इट एंड देर इज अ बैड साइड टू इट, और अ नेगेटिव अनहेल्दी साइड टू इट, लाइक देर इज टू एंगर, सैडनेस, डिसअपॉइंटमेंट, डिजेक्शन, डिस्पेयर। सो एंग्जाइटी वॉज इनिशियली designed in our system for us to be able to survive. For example, हमें survival के लिए अगर कोई difficult experience होता था, our body would prepare us through stress hormones to be able to run away or save ourselves. And that emotion used to be anxiety. There used to be stress hormones in the body, we used to prepare ourselves and we used to save ourselves.
Right.
That is a good part of anxiety. जब हम exam के लिए पढ़ते हैं, जब हम किसी presentation के लिए prepare करते हैं, पर बहुत हमारे without us being aware of it, very often anxiety becomes an unhealthy experience for a lot of us because we don't undo it when the threat has passed. And secondly, now we live in a time of perceived threat. अगर उस फ्रेंड ने मुझसे बात करनी बंद कर दी, अगर उन्होंने मुझे पार्टी में नहीं बुलाया, अगर मेरे बच्चे स्कूल में फेल हो गए या इंडिया का प्राइम मिनिस्टर नहीं बने, सो देयर इज ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ परसीव्ड थ्रेट्स दैट वी आर लिविंग इन, दैट इमोशन इज आल्सो एंग्जायटी।
व्हाट इफ, व्हाट इफ, व्हाट इफ में घुस जाते हैं।
नाउ व्हेन दैट हैपेंस, एंग्जायटी व्हिच इज आई वुड से अ नॉर्मल यूनिवर्सल इमोशन, यू नो व्हेन यू सेड कुछ लोगों को शायद एंग्जायटी के बारे में इतना पता नहीं, दैट इज समथिंग आई'd लाइक टू करेक्ट यू, मी, एवरीवन हैज एक्सपीरियंस्ड एंग्जायटी एट सम पॉइंट इन लाइफ,
राइट,
व्हिच इज व्हाई आई स्टार्टेड विद सेइंग दैट इज सच एन अमेजिंग रेलेवेंट पर्टिनेंट क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज वी ऑल नीड टू नो हाउ टू रिकॉग्नाइज इट। क्योंकि जब एंग्जायटी एंग्जायटी डिसऑर्डर में तब्दील हो जाती है, वो एक बहुत डिबिलिटेटिंग सिचुएशन हो जाती है। व्हेन देयर इज एक्सेसिव वरी, व्हेन देयर इज एक्सेसिव फियर फॉर एग्जांपल, बट वी आर सिटिंग एट होम एंड वी आर सेफ, जैसे कि मैं घर में बैठी हूँ और मुझे ये डर है कि मेरे घर में सांप आ जाएगा, मैं घर में बैठी हूँ या और मुझे ये डर है कि मुझे कोविड हो जाएगा, कोई साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स नहीं है, यू नो कोई घर में प्लान बन रहा है कि हम लोग आज हेल्थ क्लब चलते हैं, पर वहीं से किसी मेंबर को बहुत एंजाइटी शुरू हो जाती है कि नहीं वहाँ स्विमिंग पूल है, मैं गिर जाऊँगा, मैं डूब जाऊँगा. और सो यू नो वन ऑफ द थिंग्स अबाउट एंजाइटी इज दैट देयर इज एन एक्सेसिव वरी, देयर इज एक्सेसिव फियर व्हेन यू कुड एक्चुअली बी वेरी सेफ or it is disproportionate. So for example, when you're going on a flight, you understand that there is a certain amount of risk involved.
Correct.
But anxiety becomes so disproportionate that there are people who actually run away from outside of the airport or from before check-in. So anxiety is level tak experience karna ki wo ek disproportionate hamari manifestation ho jati hai. So it paralyzes you. This can impact work, it can impact school, it can impact college, it can impact social activities where you don't feel like going to parties. तो इसके manifestations काफी debilitating हो सकते हैं.
लेकिन ये होता क्यों है? Like why some people can handle anxiety well, कि वो normal हो जाते हैं कि okay उस time perceived threat था, उस पे respond किया, but then normal हो गए. लेकिन then like you're saying that there are other people जो अगर airport जा रहे हैं, लेकिन वो वहाँ से भाग के आ गए. Now, not everybody responds like that. So, ये क्यों होता है कुछ लोगों में और कुछ लोगों में नहीं होता?
I'd like to answer that in two parts.
Okay.
Number one, anxiety very often is perceived as a personal inability or weakness to bounce back or to be able to handle stress or not. And it is absolutely not that. Anxiety can be genetic, it can be because of neurotransmitters, it can be because of a hormonal imbalance, it can also be because of brain physiology, which are four biological significant causes of anxiety. So we have to understand that this is not something that is caused you know as a person's choice or inability to deal with stress.
Right.
So, for example, I'll give you one example of a cause. An overactive amygdala, for example, in our brain, where fear centers are overactive. So, for you may get over anxiety or an anxious experience quickly, but mine might be slightly different and I may take longer. There are largely some neurotransmitters and hormones that are associated with anxiety, namely serotonin glutamate or cortisol and adrenaline. Now, when there is a neurotransmitter imbalance, these neurotransmitters are basically chemical messengers between cells of brain. Jo hamara brain hai, it is made up of cells. These cells are not tightly connected with each other. There's a slight gap between them. These are known as synaptic gaps.
Yeah.
Is gap ke beech mein ek chemical ट्रांसपोर्ट करता है मैसेजेस को. दोज केमिकल्स आर नोन एज ट्रांसमिटर, न्यूरोट्रांसमिटर्स. एंड व्हेन देयर इज एन इंबैलेंस इन दिस कम्युनिकेशन थ्रू दिस न्यूरोट्रांसमिटर्स, देयर कैन बी एंजाइटी. नाउ दिस इज नॉट समथिंग इन अ यू नो इन द हैंड्स ऑफ अ पर्सन. सिमिलरली यू नो एक्सेसिव कॉर्टिसोल और एक्सेसिव एड्रेनालिन, देयर कैन बी हार्मोनल इंबैलेंसेस. सो दिस इज यू नो द बायोलॉजिकल रीजन. द सेकंड इज a psychological reason where there is excessive worry about the future. There are certain personality types, belief systems, jahan future ke bare mein bahut chinta karte hain.
Mostly like mothers. Most mothers are constantly worried ke future mein kya hone wala hai, future mein kya hone wala hai.
Yes, really. Yeah. That is that becomes like a side effect, you know, of birthing a baby. So for example, cognition, your perception or your thought errors, of catastrophizing, of magnifying things that might go wrong, you know, in life or in future, your own future, your children's future, your husband's future, etc.
Correct.
So those are some psychological concerns. There are a lot of stressors that everybody experiences. For example, it can be illness, loss of a job, loss of a you know loved one, or finances. You know, a move between two cities, just a transition period like we've all gone through in the last so many months.
Correct.
A lot of uncertainty. Also social settings for some people, these are all extremely threatening for these particular people. Again, I'd like to reiterate, this is not a personal weakness. It is a way in which they have started to think because of their experiences. So these are some of, you know, the causes. Like you said, hota kya hai body mein? What goes
Correct.
Wrong?
Yeah.
Now, the other thing quickly, you know, that I'd like to talk about is that जैसे कि मैंने पहले कहा, एंग्जाइटी हमारा एक स्ट्रेस रिस्पॉन्स होता था फॉर सर्वाइवल, फाइट फ्लाइट और फ्रीज. हमें एंग्जाइटी होती थी, वी यूज्ड टू फील थ्रेट, आवर बॉडी यूज्ड टू यू नो द हाइपोथैलेमस वुड क्विकली गिव अ मैसेज टू द पिट्यूटरी व्हिच वुड क्विकली गिव अ मैसेज टू द एड्रेनल ग्लैंड्स कि ग्लुकोकॉर्टिकॉइड्स रिलीज करो बिकॉज वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर द बॉडी टू रन. ग्लूकोज सारा हमारे बिग मोटर मसल्स में डालो, यू नो, लेट द पर्सन थिंक हार्ड, लेट द पर्सन थाई मसल्स बी स्ट्रॉन्गर. सो वी वुड प्रिपेयर फॉर दिस काइंड ऑफ फाइट ऑफ फ्लाइट. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस विद द एग्जैक्ट सेम हॉर्मोन एंड न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर इन आवर बॉडी इन द लॉन्ग टर्म. व्हेन देयर इज नो थ्रेट, व्हेन देयर इज परसीव्ड थ्रेट, और वी आर रिलीजिंग दीज day after day with being threatened for our jobs, being threatened for our children, being threatened with social media, being threatened that we lose followers. So these are the presence of the same thing that helps us survive can lead to long-term stress-related disorders. So what happens when you know, when there is a beast chasing out of after us and we need to save ourselves, the brain says tum, you know, digestion postpone kar do, फर्टिलिटी पोस्टपोन कर दो, कोई बात नहीं, राइट नाउ वी डोंट नीड अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग इम्यून सिस्टम, वी नीड टू रन फास्टर, वी डोंट रियली नीड द ग्रोथ हार्मोन. सो अ लॉट ऑफ सिस्टम्स इन आवर बॉडी आर कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड बिकॉज द रिसोर्सेज हैव टू बी चैनलाइज्ड टुवर्ड्स सर्वाइवल. बट कैन यू इमेजिन व्हेन दैट हैपेंस इन द लॉन्ग टर्म, देन वी कैन हैव डाइजेस्टिव इश्यूज. You know, correct. Coming to your question, I'm trying to answer that question of yours, what happens when when we are anxious? These are the things that you will notice. There might be ulcerations, colitis, myopathy, fatigue, you know, diabetes, hypertension. These have become like epidemics also.
It's very interesting what you're saying, कि अगर एक चीज रुक जाती है तो I mean बाकी चीजें रुक जाती हैं, just to put that one thing in forefront, and in the bargain the entire body starts suffering, and then we wonder कि अरे अगर एक बीमारी है तो पूरी बॉडी को असर क्यों हो रहा है, but this is the reason why पूरी बॉडी पे असर हो रहा है.
Exactly. Okay. To the extent that there can be brain and neuronal damage. There's also research has proved that there is neuronal death, which basically is irreversible. So anxiety in that sense is extremely debilitating. And we definitely need to start looking into finding a better way of life where we can cut down, you know, this long-term anxious feeling.
राइट राइट. सो देन नेचुरली नेक्स्ट स्टेप ये है कि अगर अगर किसी के साथ हो रहा है, मान लो यू नो अराउंड मी से समवन इन माय फैमिली और वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स और मे बी इवन आई एम गोइंग थ्रू इट, लेकिन आई एम नॉट अवेयर दैट आई एम गोइंग थ्रू इट, तो क्या कोई ऐसे साइंस हैं विच आई कैन वॉच आउट फॉर, विच आई कैन एक्चुअली ऑब्जर्व एंड से ओके अगर ये और ये हो रहा है, मतलब आई शुड कनेक्ट विद यू नो विद अ डॉक्टर एंड लेट देम नो कि मेरे साथ ये हो रहा है. So are there any such signs which we can just point out?
Absolutely.
In life?
Yes, there are. And again, I think it is something that needs to become household knowledge, signs and signs and symptoms of anxiety. The first one is physiological, which are basically somatic in nature. Some of the first signs you will observe in yourself or in someone else is shortness of breath, when they are taking very short breaths, when they're sweating. When there's a you know, sleep disturbance, they will wake up very early or not be able to sleep in the night. There's muscle tension, they're constantly, you know, there's tightening of muscles. There's tachycardia, which is basically palpitation. So you will start to experience a lot of physiological symptoms, clenched fist, clenched jaws, a sense of discomfort. And you will see it, you will feel it in your own body, and you will see it in a loved one when there is anxiety, edginess, nervousness, walking around, pacing, shaking of you know, legs over and over again. So these are some of those, you know, ticks and twitches that you might notice. Right. Second is cognitive, which is maybe harder to understand unless you're really in a conversation with someone and you know them well, because their conversation will constantly be about what will go wrong in the future. One of the mistakes that we people as family and friends do is we might shut them down by saying, itna negative mat socha. You know, why are you constantly thinking about bad things? Think positive.
Yeah.
But there we have missed a very subtle sign of a distress call by another person when they are actually maybe catastrophizing something or magnifying something that is going wrong. So these are some of the things that we can observe. You know, the other thing which is more psychosocial in nature, if you observe that a friend or a loved one is consistently refusing to go out, doesn't want to do the things that they used to earlier enjoy, or they are not being able to enjoy normally pleasurable things like going out to a party with friends, going out for drinks. So that is another very subtle cue that you can take if it's happening over a period of time, where you can reach out to them and say, you know, hey, do you want to talk about this?
Right. So, I mean, it's very difficult to reach out to a person, because first reaction hamesha, if somebody is going through it, hamesha, at least maine observe kiya hai, hamesha wo yehi kehte hain, no, you won't get it. Nobody will understand me. Nobody will get it. I don't want to talk about it. So in that case, one, I want to understand what is the worst that can happen if one goes through a anxiety attack. And the second is ke first response, agar main apne aas paas kisi ko dekhun, ke agar unme ye ho raha hai, and right now they're going into a phase where, you know, kuch zyada hi ho raha hai, because they are not acknowledging it, they haven't gone to a doctor. So as a first aid help, what can I offer help immediately before I reach out to their doctor?
Shruti, the first thing, one of the reasons why people shut us down and say you won't understand is because they think only they are experiencing it.
Yeah.
So even though you may feel at that time, no, I want a magic wand to make this person feel better, it's always better, best to, even if you think it's a little bit of a waste of time, to start with, you know what, I've been there, I know what anxiety feels like. And you won't be lying, because you have been anxious. I have been anxious in my life at various points in life. So just to identify, put a word to that emotion and say, hey, what you're going through is anxiety, and this is absolutely fine. I've been there. I'm right here, and we're going to walk you through this together.
Right.
Then in terms of first aid, I think the first thing to start with is to help them loosen up muscles. Like I mentioned in signs and symptoms, tightened muscles reduce the utilization of oxygen in our body, resulting in hypoxia, with less oxygen reaching the brain. So you remind them that, is it possible for you to unclench your jaw? Can you drop your shoulders down? Could you unclench your fists? You know, entangle your legs, relax your feet, and will you breathe by your belly with me? So this is if you're doing it for somebody else, and if you have to do it with yourself, then you also have to remind yourself that, okay, I'm going to do some heavy belly breathing, because you need copious amounts of oxygen in your body, relax your muscles, and you need to send that oxygen into your brain and your bloodstream to be able to cut down the impact of the extreme cortisol.
Right.
The second thing I would do for myself and anyone else is take the gadget away. I think where gadgets have become a very significant trigger. For various kinds of reasons, and there's no judgment on that. But at that time, in that moment, we can take the gadget away. The third thing to do is to remind ourselves and anchor ourselves in the present moment. So it's like you will stick your feet in there strong and stay in the present moment.
Right.
The best way to do that, now it's easier for me to say, right? How the hell does somebody pay attention to the present? Of course I'm in the present. I'm not going anywhere else. So how are you going to achieve it? The first most useful way is breathing. So you could tell a person that, you know what, try focusing on the air that's going in through your nostrils and coming out. I'm not asking you to breathe in any particular way, but just, can you just focus on the oxygen going in and the carbon dioxide coming out? Breathing is a great way to bring your attention to the present. Why are you trying to bring that attention to the present? Because anxious people are essentially threatened about the future. What will happen next? The second thing you could do is use your various modalities. You could choose one focal point in the distance, ask the person to close their eyes, and just keep imagining, visualizing what they had seen, and keep their focus on that.
Right.
You could also ask them to focus on three things that they can hear while their eyes are shut. So it could be anything. It could be from whispers to the loudest noises. But tell them to just focus their modality on listening. या फिर आपके एनवायरनमेंट में आपको क्या तीन चीजें दिख रही हैं उसकी डिटेल्स ऑब्जर्व करिए. इज देयर एनी वन थिंग दैट यू कैन आइडेंटिफाई जिसकी आपको खुशबू आ रही है और स्मेल, यू नो, कैन यू, इज देयर एनीथिंग दैट यू कैन टेस्ट. वेरी ऑफन यू विल गेट एन आंसर दैट नो, माय माउथ इज कंप्लीटली ड्राई. यू नो, यू कैन गिव देम अ सिप ऑफ वाटर एंड से कैन यू फोकस ऑन द वे यू आर टेस्टिंग दैट वाटर, हाउ इट्स गोइंग डाउन योर थ्रोट एंड मेकिंग यू फील बेटर. एंड ऑफ कोर्स टैक्टाइल, टैक्टाइल इज बेसिकली रिलेटेड टू touch. Are there two or three sensations that you can feel? Just the way your clothes are feeling on your body, just the way the hot air is feeling, you know, above your lips. So those are the things that you can use in terms of first aid to bring the person to the present and try and avoid all of the
literal physical senses jo hain, jo hamare panch senses hain, we need to use those and get a person down to literally that. Now that's very, very interesting, and I think it's very helpful also. So now in the whole anxiety ka game, like, you know, the whole thing which is going on, what is that one advice that you would like to give our listeners, something that we have not spoken about till right now and something that you feel is very, very important for them to know for themselves and dusron ke liye, ki anxiety mein unko kya ek aisi baat dhyan mein rakhni chahiye?
I think the one thing that I'd like to say is that there's a lot of hope when it comes to remission, when it comes to anxiety. When we experience anxiety, ye emotion itna debilitating hota hai, Shruti, that we start, and in any case, the emotion also comes from a cognitive error that the worst is going to happen, that we forget that this is treatable. And right. I really want to create awareness for people that anxiety can be behind you within a few months of active, consistent, you know, and motivated therapy, because the prognosis for anxiety is good. We don't have to sit over it for years and years, live, you know, with those stress hormones in our body, wait till it manifests multiple other physiological problems and then deal with it. So this is the one thing that I want to leave people with, is that when you experience anxiety, like, you would not think twice to reach out to a doctor if there is, you know, a headache or a stomachache or, you know, just even a regular eye checkup or a dental checkup, even if nothing's going wrong. Right. Do that with anxiety, because the times are changing. There are a lot of triggers that have increased in our lifestyle, in our environment. So anxiety is something that can have manifestations if we let it become chronic. But if you identify it well in time, it has, you know, beautiful prognosis. Very quickly we can help you put it behind you. So I guess that what I'm trying to say is that please don't lose hope. It's not something that you can't change. It's not something that you can't treat.
And the best part is it's treatable. So zyada sochne ka nahi, karne ka. Reach out to your doctor so that the doctor can fix you for good. So which is amazing.
Very well put.
But Shwetamra, thank you so much for taking out your precious time and, like, literally educating us on this. Because ye bahut zaruri cheez hai jo hume pata nahi lagti, you know. And it's very difficult to just reach out and ask someone when one doesn't know. So thank you. Thank you so much for this.
Most welcome, Shruti. Thank you for having me.
तो कैसा लगा आपको आज का एपिसोड ऑन माय सेकंड नेचर? मैं हूँ श्रुति, एंड इफ यू वांट टू गेट इन टच विद डॉक्टर श्वेताम्बरा सबरवाल, उनकी डिटेल्स राइटअप में लिखी हैं, आप वहां से ले सकते हैं. तो चलिए मैं चलती हूँ. आई विल सी यू द नेक्स्ट टाइम राइट हियर ऑन माय सेकंड नेचर.